Frame family, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we are going to talk about the unveiling of what the RX 6000 series GPUs will look like, and we also have some leaked benchmarks of an unnamed AMD GPU as well. Now keep in mind, there's nothing official about these leaked benchmarks, so obviously take it with a grain of salt, but this might give us an idea of what performance levels we may see out of AMD's RDNA 2 GPUs in a little over a month from now. With that disclaimer out of the way, let's just get into it. So recently, AMD shared a picture on Twitter showcasing what the RX 6000 GPU's design will look like, and I'm kind of digging it. Thanks to this reveal, we now know ahead of the October 28th event that these reference cards will be a two-slot design sporting three cooling fans and will be powered by two 8-pin PCIe power connectors. We can also see on top of the card that there is a red trim that matches the Radeon Red themed text, and I would assume that both the trim and the text, or at least just the text, will light up, but we'll have to see if my speculation there is true or not later next month. Another thing I want to mention with this reveal, although AMD's wording makes it seem like all of their RX 6000 cards will hold this design, we know that AMD is planning three main GPU lines: the NAVI 21, aka RX 6900 or Big NAVI line, which will compete with Nvidia's RTX 3080 and above; NAVI 22, which is said to compete with the RTX 3070 and 3060; and the NAVI 23 model, which is said to compete with anything below the 3060. We also know that after recent leaks from Rogame that AMD is releasing four different SKUs for their NAVI 21 GPU and at least two for their NAVI 22 at some point, if not right away. That being said, this design we are seeing may not be identical for all their next-gen GPUs, especially their low to mid-tier models, but it can be assumed that this is on the higher end of the spectrum as it has two 8-pin connectors matching what we will see out of the RTX 3070 and in some cases even the RTX 3080. But regardless, it's exciting to know what we can visually expect out of these cards, and I think they look pretty clean. But the interesting sauce does not end there, and you all know I love the sauce. One of the most interesting leaks recently in the GPU world is that of a benchmark while playing Ashes of the Singularity on an AMD GPU that has no official designation. Of course, with more than 6 SKUs being planned for release by AMD in their next gen lineup, it's hard to pinpoint which specific model this benchmark could represent. But from the pictures shown, we can see that this GPU was able to achieve an average FPS of 63.9 on the crazy 4K preset, which puts it on par with an RTX 2080 Ti in terms of performance, but still leaves it at over 50% slower than an RTX 3080. This could either be great or bad news depending on what card was used in this benchmark. For example, if it's a NAVI 22 model or even the most affordable of the NAVI 21 models costing under or at $500, then it will provide equal to or better performance as the RTX 3070 for the same or less cost. This would then leave room for AMD to have more GPU SKUs capable of competing with the RTX 3080s like rumors have suggested. However, if this is AMD's flagship GPU that costs more than an RTX 3070 but provides similar performance with not many other options above it, if any at all, to compete with Nvidia's RTX 3080, then we might see a lot of criticism sent AMD's way for falling behind this generation on both performance and release timeframes. I personally hope that this is AMD's RTX 3070 competing card and that they have many options available for us this year to really bring the competition. After all, I am on the side of the consumers, so if both companies are able to provide great performance for a great cost to stay competitive, I consider that a win for every one of us. But I want to know your guys' thoughts on this. What do you guys think of the new AMD GPU designs? And do you think these benchmarks are vindicative of AMD's top-of-the-line cards, or do you think they're going to bring the fire this year? Let me know down in the comments below, but that's all I have for you guys in this video. Remember to smack that like button so YouTube will show off this video to others who might enjoy it as well. As always, fam, it's been a pleasure. Please stay safe, stay happy, and keep on gaming.